paper today is about a comparison of the clinical outcomes between image-guided system versus the smartphone digital reference marker app for toric intraocular lens implantation in cataract surgery. No financial disclosures, and the accuracy of the toric IL depends on the following factors: appropriate patient selection, accuracy of the biometry and keratometry, the calculator being used, the accuracy of the preoperative reference markings, the IOL placement in the capsular bag, and the rotational stability of the IOL. So for the smartphone assisted digital reference markers, apps like the iToric, Patwardhan, or the ToriCam can be used, which are available online. And the Varian guidance delivers better outcomes than slit lamp assisted conventional manual ink marking techniques in terms of induced astigmatism, as has been proved in various studies earlier. So in this study, we intend to compare between the Varian image guided system and the iToric smartphone digital reference marker app, the clinical outcomes with respect to uncorrected distance visual acuity, residual astigmatism, and deviation from the target residual astigmatism in a toric IL cataract surgery. And to our knowledge, there has been no previous published studies or reports of this. So this is a prospective randomized clinical study conducted at a tertiary eye care center. The sample size for the smartphone digital reference marking app was 10, and that for the Varian group was 13. To reduce the confounding variables, a detailed slit lamp evaluation, topography, and OCT was done for every patient, and patients with any ocular surface disorders, corneal or retinal pathologies, or any other eye problems were not included in the study. Keratometry was done on multiple devices, and an integrated K reading was taken in calculation wherever there was a discrepancy in the K readings between the devices. Biometry was performed by immersion method, and Barrett's online toric calculator was used. To reduce any IL-related confounding factors like rotational stability, Acrisoft IQ toric platform T3 to T9 was used in all the cases. No rotation was encountered in our study, and surgeries were performed by a single surgeon, and no intraoperative complications were encountered. So this is how the smartphone marking was done in the study. And by taking into account the gyroscopic assisted camera rotation, we get the effective mark rotation from the 0 to 180 degree, and then the Mendes ring is accordingly applied. For the Varian image guided group, it automatically corrects for the cyclotorsion by recognizing the scleral landmarks of the iris and limbus. And this was how the Varian helped us in our study. So in this study, we are using the uncorrected visual acuity, best corrected visual acuity, residual astigmatism, and deviation from the target residual astigmatism as a measure of the clinical outcome of toric IL surgery. The data was entered in Microsoft Excel, and using the software, mean and standard deviation was calculated for the different samples, and unequal variance of independent unpaired t-test was done to analyze for any significant difference between the two groups. So these are the Excel sheets, and we found that the post-operative uncorrected distance visual acuity of all the eyes in both the groups was 6.9 or logMAR 0.18 and better. So the data was tabulated, and the T value was derived. And as we can see that this mean of the deviation of the residual astigmatism from the target anticipated astigmatism is the best evaluation for post-refractive outcome. So now these T values were put to the T test, and it was found to be not significant. So our results demonstrated that there's no significant difference between the UCVA, best corrected visual acuity, and deviation from the anticipated residual astigmatism in both the groups. So using Varian over smartphone app did not lead to any significant improvement with respect to clinical outcomes. Advantages of this current study is that the earlier studies demonstrated a strong agreement between the Varian and the smartphone axis marking, but assumed Varian as the gold standard for accurate alignment of the toric IOLs. But in the considerable advantage in the design of the current study is the ability to independently evaluate and compare the clinical outcomes of the two marking systems. This study provides results obtained by a single surgeon, though this helps eliminate surgeon variables like the surgically induced astigmatism, effective lens position, surgeon-related alignment accuracy. A multivariate evaluation can be performed in the future. So to conclude, smartphone digital reference marking apps are a cheap, consistent, easily available reproducible way of enhancing outcomes of torticollis but needs a lot of care, precision, and is prone to transcription errors, where an image-guided study aims to make the process of torticollis alignment more accurate. It enhances the surgical flow, especially in a high-volume centers, but due to its high cost, it may not be an economically viable option for the majority of ophthalmologists. And there is no significant difference in uncorrected distance visual acuity, residual refractive astigmatism, or deviation from the target anticipated residual astigmatism between the image-guided digital marking group and versus the smartphone digital reference marking group in torticollis surgery. I would like to acknowledge Dr. Saurabh Patwardhan for his iToric app and Dr. Siddharth Gupta for the statistical courtesy. These are the references. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.
Dr. Swati, very nice presentations.
Thank you, sir. And
especially you have ruled out the differences between the two groups by your process. So nice presentation, and I hope your presentation will help a lot of doctors who are not capable or cannot afford buying variants. So thank you. Nice presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Swati, nice presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Between these two systems, how do you compare these two image-guided system and the smartphone with the manual one? Manual, you have any idea?
Yes, sir.
The difference?
Yes, sir. So they have, the manual ones have been done in multiple studies earlier, and they have been compared with the Varian and the smartphone. So that was not a new study, and they have shown an error of around 4 to 6 degrees plus minus 2. So that has already been said that there is a strong difference. But Varian, the smartphone was already held comparable to the Varian in most of the earlier studies. So in this study, we've shown that the clinical efficiency is equal. And when those conventional manual marking techniques are showing to do an error, then we don't now need to do the conventional manual marking techniques. Rather, we can upgrade to the smartphone digital marking apps, which is so easily available in everyone's hand, free of cost. So that is the aim of the study.
Basically, the conventional one is because of the different person. When two persons or different persons do it, it is because of the errors, you know, technical errors while doing marking the error. So what are the chances of error in your technique?
So the chances of error, we've done, this thing is there's no chances of error. Pardon, sir?
Person to person error
with the smartphone. So the smartphone, it is a digitally referenced marker. So there is not supposed to be any person to person error. It will, that can always happen with the Varian also, and that can happen with the surgeries also, sir. So the precision of the surgeon will always be there for any surgery or any surgeon. So we need to definitely take care of all that.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Swati, what is the learning curve for using the smartphone thing? Is it very easy or?
Sir, it's very easy for people. It's just like an app. It's so simple.
So that will be very useful for using in day-to-day clinical practice, isn't it?
Yes, sir. I mean, it's much easier. It's just an app. You just have to open and take a photograph with that app and draw protractor through the central of pupil and the limbal mark. That's it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.